Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with a new video about how to work with the Telewiki and the client server configuration using Node.js. In several of the last videos we had a closer look at how we can create a client server configuration, how we can activate it, how we can install and uninstall plugins, and now we will have a closer look about using custom plugins, so let's say third-party plugins. And for this there is some general information which needs to be known. So there is installing custom plugins on Node.js in the Tiller. Then there is an important information, is the plugin load order. How does Telewiki with Node.js load the different plugins? When the server starts, it first has a look at the plugins using the operating system environment variables. So there are two elements which are important. There are plugin folders, which defines the structure of the plugin folder, and the environment variables with Node.js. So there will be some other videos where we cover every point of these four elements. So first, check the environment variables for plugins, and if they are found, use them. Then the next one is a plugin folder directly in the project path of the for example my new wiki path. This is the next one. Then there are some plugins that can be specified with the command line, and then there are the plugins which are imported by drag and drop. And the important part here is elements lower in the list take precedence, and that's important. So for Telewiki, user content will always win. So if someone makes some changes to plugins, then they are the last one in the list, and then they will be activated. So for example, we did not activate it again. So import save, so we import the menu bar again and restart the client server. If I open it, and then now it uses the Telewiki environment variable, in this case part of the official plugins, and it starts the menu bar. And now if I start to edit elements here with those tiddlers, then those tillers will be saved as part of the wiki, as the wiki content, and then they will be activated last. And that's important. So in normal cases, user content in Telewiki will always win. Okay, then there is one more thing. With Telewiki there are two types of plugins. There are plugins that are used for the Node.js version itself. For example, the file system and the TiddlyWeb plugin, they are needed by the Node.js version to have access to the file system. And those elements, they have to be activated with settings in the telewiki.info file, because if you import them by drag and drop, they will only work in the browser, and that's important. So if you go back here, this is this paragraph. So if you include plugins as ordinary tiddlers, they will only be activated in the browser. They will not be available under Node.js. So for Node.js it's important to use telewiki.info. Then option one is the most common one. It lowers the maintenance, because if you define plugins and Telewiki, the server can find them on places, you can update these plugins on this one or with this one place, and every server which uses those plugins will be updated automatically. So this is an advantage, but it also could be a disadvantage because it may be a configuration that you have not tested. Yeah? That's why there is option 2. Yeah? So local plugin paths. So if I open my wiki and if I create a new path here, and I say plugins, yeah, they will be always part of the configuration. Yeah? So they will be part of my new wiki. And if this is the configuration that you tested, it will be always the same. Yeah? And that's important. So this option is preferred if you want to work with a fixed configuration that will not change even if you update your global elements. Yeah? So let's say this is for production where it's important that that the changes, or if something is changed, if it needs to be tested, it is always tested. Yeah? Then there is an option to start every wiki. So even if it is not configured as a client server configuration, yeah, so for example, if those two plugins are missing from the TillyWiki info file, it will still be possible to start them in that way. Yeah? So we will test if there is some information as using TillyWiki on Node.js. And then there is the drag and drop testing, as I showed you in the other video where we had where we did import the menu bar plugin, yeah, where I did start with drag and dropping it. So have a look at this video. There will be links in the video description. Okay, and in the next video we will have a closer look about how to deal with environment variables and an overview about the plugin folder. How can we include third-party plugins? Yeah, that's it for the moment. If you like the videos, if the videos make difference to you, yeah, working with TillyWiki, then please like and subscribe. It will make a difference for me too. Have fun!